Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from InkNote. Today we're going to be going over a few different PowerPoint plugins that teachers can use to create more engaging and creative lessons. There are hundreds of different add-ins out there that you can look at, but today we're just going to focus on five specifically for your classroom. The first that I recommend is ClassPoint. Of course, we love ClassPoint here, but for a good reason. ClassPoint is a tool that can build up interactivity in your lessons by asking students questions and receiving live responses from them, all done right through PowerPoint. To get the ClassPoint add-in, you can just go to classpoint.io and click download now. Once ClassPoint is downloaded and installed, you can sign in and then you'll have access to all of the ClassPoint features, including these different pen colors, the ability to add whiteboard slides into your presentation, and five different interactive question types. So if you have a question in your lesson that you want to ask your students, you simply just need to click on the question type that you want to have, and we'll paste a button right on your slide. The side question panel has different settings for your question, along with different play options. When you go into your presentation mode, students can join your class by going to classpoint.app and using this class code in the corner. Once you've clicked on the button to open up the question, students can begin answering the question and you'll see the responses live on screen. The ClassPoint toolbar at the bottom of the screen makes it really easy for you to add annotations anywhere on your slides, along with highlighting or even adding blank whiteboard slides. ClassPoint is a great tool for a variety of different engagement opportunities. So if you're interested in learning more about this add-in, you can check out the other videos on our channel. This second one is one of my personal favorites. It's Pixton Comic Characters. This allows you to create and add the comic characters into your PowerPoint presentation. To get this add-in, you can go over to the Insert tab and click on Add-ins and then Get Add-ins. And in the search bar here, you can just type Pixton and click Add. Once you have the add-in, you can find it on the Home tab in the top ribbon. Then you can just click on Pixton Characters and the side panel will open up. So we can go ahead and get started in creating our first character. So you have four different types to choose from, and then you can pick their hair color and their hairstyle. And you have a whole slew of different outfits to choose from. So since our presentation is about swimming, we can add this girl here who's in a workout outfit. And then you can pick from a variety of different poses. So here's one where she's drinking some water. And then you can just edit and rearrange your character on slide however you want. In addition, you might want to add in a text bubble so that your character can say something. This Pixton add-in can add some fun into your class. You can create a little mascot for your class that is on every slide and kind of helps the students through, or you can just use them to reinforce different topics throughout your lesson. The third one I have for you guys is Pexels. So Pexels provides a little bit more variety and options than the stock images that PowerPoint already has in their application. So in the same way we got Pixton, you can get Pexels and the add-ins coming up from the Insert tab and Add-ins and Get Add-ins. Then you can just search for Pexels and click Add. Once Pexels is added, you can find it also in the Insert tab all the way at the end. So you can just click on the add-in and it will open up the side panel. So let's add a photo to this slide here. So along with searching by text, you can also search by color, which is pretty unique. So if you have a color scheme already going for your presentation, you can stick with that. So let's search for something blue here. And you will be provided with all of these different photo options. When you found one that you like, you can just click on it and it will insert onto your slide. And then you're free to edit as you wish. My fourth recommendation is the break time add-in. So this add-in is actually a timer that you can insert and embed into your PowerPoint presentation. So it's pretty flexible. You don't just have to use it for breaks. You can use it for group activities, or if you're giving students time to do some of their work. To get this add-in, in the same way, we can just go insert, add-ins, get add-ins, and search for break time. If you don't see break time on the ribbon, you can always just go to My Add-ins and click on break time and click add. But I'm actually going to put this add-in on its own slide at the middle end of my presentation before we get into some of the heavier stuff. So I can add my timer in on this slide. Once it's on screen, you can also move this around and you can have it cover the whole slide if you want, or just a portion of it, depending on how you want your slides to look. So you can set the time of your timer along with the type. So you can define the type to add in a photo in the back of your timer. When you go into your presentation mode, your timer is right on screen and you can click start right from here. And then all of your students will be able to see how much time they have left to work or how much time they have left in their break. My last recommendation for you guys is FET Simulations. This add-in is specifically for math and science teachers. It allows you to add interactive STEM simulations right into your PowerPoint presentations. So this is a wonderful way for students to visualize cause and effect and visualize some other tough concepts. To get this add-in, you can do it in the same way we did our previous three, and you can add it to a blank slide. So I have it in my add-ins here, and you will see that it looks pretty similar to our break time timer at the beginning. So I can move this around and I'm gonna make it full screen. You guys can see all of the different simulations that can be run with this add-in. So since we're talking about swimming, we can do the waves intro here. And then you can insert it into your presentation and then choose water, sound, or light. So for this example, we'll just go with water. And you can run it here in edit mode, but you can also run it while you're in presentation mode as if you're teaching your students. So with this add-in, you can change the frequency and the amplitude, along with adding a graph on screen, and then we can push the button to see the water coming out of the pipe and how waves are created. I would love to hear if you guys are using this add-in or any of the previous ones that I mentioned. I love to learn just as much as you. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on notifications so that you can be notified whenever we come out with a new video all about tech in the classroom.